Hey, it's Harry, and today we're going to be looking at how easy it is to get set up with your iD44 MkII audio interface. In the box, you'll find the following items: your iD44, a quick start guide, a USB C2C cable, a USB C2A cable, and a power adapter. Firstly, we need to connect iD44 to your computer. So start by selecting the correct regional power supply and connect it to the power adapter. Next, plug it directly into your wall power supply and connect the other end to iD44. Now connect either the USB-C or the USB-A cable, depending on the ports available on your computer, and you can now turn on iD44 using the power switch on the back. iD44 will work on both Mac and Windows computers, but first you need to download the driver from our website. This gives you access to the iD mixer and also allows you to control iD44 MkII. If you're using a Mac, open the downloaded file and then drag the iD app into your applications. When you open it, a little iD icon will appear in the menu bar and give you access to the various settings. To set iD44 as your Mac sound device, simply open up your system preferences, go to sound, and select iD44 as your input and output device. If you're using Windows, open the downloaded driver file and simply follow the steps in the installer. Once installed, you can then open the Windows Settings app, go to sound, and select iD44 as your input and output device. On older versions of Windows, this can be done from the sound menu in Control Panel. When you open the iD app, an iD icon will appear in the system tray, which you can then right-click on to gain access to various features and settings on iD44. Now that you have your iD44 connected to your computer, it's time to get some audio going. So firstly, plug in your speakers using one or both sets of the outputs on the rear of the unit, or connect a set of headphones to one of the outputs on the front. The volume of these can be adjusted using the main knob on the top of the unit or the individual headphone controls. Provided you have set iD44 as your sound device, if you now play any audio from your computer, whether from an audio software or music application, you should see signal appearing in the meters and you should hear audio. To start recording, use either the XLR inputs on the back for a microphone or use the instrument inputs on the front for guitars or basses. The instrument inputs will come in on channels 1 and 2 and will replace anything that's plugged in to the XLR inputs 1 and 2. If you're using a microphone that uses phantom power, then make sure you flick the 48-volt toggle switch on the channel that you're using. And you can also make use of other input conditioning features, such as a high-pass filter to reduce rumble or pads for especially loud signals. You can quickly set your input levels using the gain knobs on the top of iD44. To check your input levels, you can either look in your audio software or you can open up the iD mixer. Simply go to the menu bar on a Mac or the system tray on a PC and open up the iD menu and select Show Mixer. Now you can see the level of your inputs in the iD mixer. We recommend turning up the inputs until the loudest peak is at around -12 dB. If you want to make use of the ultra-low latency monitoring, you can turn up any of the input faders and you will hear an ultra-low latency copy of your inputs in your speakers or your headphones. And in the same way, you can reduce or mute your computer audio using these door channels as well. For more information on how to use the iD mixer, please watch the iD mixer overview video. Now, simply create a new channel in your audio software and set the correct inputs, and you're ready to start recording. Make sure that you subscribe to this channel for more videos and tutorials on recording with iD44. And if you need any help getting set up, head over to the help pages on our website or get in touch and we'd be more than happy to help you out.